So let's start with the CCAR and DFAST again. So you have the Basel models with you, out of which you have been calculating your losses, expected and unexpected losses. But still the 2008 recession came and whole banking industry went for a toss. Because of that, the Federal Bank in US came up with a fact that external factors in the economy sometimes can play a very big role while you're talking about the risk existing in your portfolio. It can happen that all your internal variables or the variables which you have taken from the bureau might be performing fine, your models might be fine, but there could be some extreme external conditions which will take your complete portfolio for a toss. So to cover this, what Federal Bank has started, that every bank having an asset of more than 50 billion in total has to undergo this annual stress test and along with that these large bank holding companies which are called BHCs commonly while you are doing us any kind of CCAR DFAST model, they have to complete these regulatory requirements mandatorily. And along with all the model specifications, the methodologies which you have used in while developing the models, the complete documentation has to be provided to the Federal Bank. And after that, these results are declared. So I will give you a brief example. It started in 2011. And around 2012 or 13, the second largest bank, I would say now the largest bank in terms of outstanding credit card outstanding, Citibank, failed the CCAR test. And in a day, within the day, the results were declared, the stock prices of Citibank plummeted. So, if your regulatory authority does not approve the way you conduct your business, your investors, your depositors will lose the confidence in you, and the bank holding companies or the banks will face a severe business hit. So CCAR and DFAST is a qualitative and quantitative assessment of bank holding companies' capital position, and they help the banks to plan and strengthen their risk management process. And when in 2013 a bank failed the test, they have to resubmit their complete capital adequacy plan again to the central bank. So it's a huge blow and it's a huge hit for any bank when the Federal Bank says that your methods of running your business are not good. Now when I talk about the stress test, so there are different macroeconomic variables which are taken into account while preparing the models. So, large bank holding companies, they are asked to prepare their own macroeconomic scenarios at a first stage. So, according to their calculations, what are the different macroeconomic variables which are existing in the economy right now? They can take a reference from lot of sources. But they have to prepare their own macroeconomic scenario and then try to run the models which they are building, or the CCAR DFAST models which they are building. The most important thing here is the BHC scenarios are divided into three parts. So one is baseline, one is adverse, and one is severely adverse. So baseline scenario is a normal scenario. If the economy is going on a normal platform, what could be my different macroeconomic indicators like GDP growth rate, inflation rate, housing price index, which is an indicator of inflation rate, and unemployment rate. So these kind of variables are used. So there are around a set of 20 to 30 macro. Yes, Mrinmoy, I am a 34. So there is around a set of 20 to 30 macroeconomic variables which are prescribed by the Federal Bank, which can be used while preparing the model. But when you prepare any model, mostly the number of variables in your model can go up to 8 or 10 at max. So as a first step, you identify which are the macroeconomic variables which can be statistically taken into account while preparing the model, or which are the true indicators of the economy. For example, when you make CCAR DFAST model, there is a variable called Dow Jones Index. That is also given as an option to prepare CCAR DFAST model. But when we were preparing the CCAR DFAST models, we discussed this variable with the business stakeholders and the people who are working since long into this field. So they are of the view that this variable is not a true representer of the economy. Because it is related to stock market, and stock market is highly speculative in nature. So if a person has a speculation that the economy will go better in some further days, and this information spreads in the stock market, my stock prices will jump. And if somehow a misinformation goes out in the stock market that a particular company is going to go bad in the future period, the stock prices might get plummeted within few days just out of the misinformation. So the kind of information you are getting from a particular variable, and in this case the stock market or Dow Jones Index, it is not a true representative of the economy, but it is more speculative in nature. So we did not used to use this variable. Apart from that, housing price index is a true indicator of the state of the economy. Similarly, if you talk about unemployment rate or GDP quarter on quarter growth rate, this also represents the health of your economy directly. So these variables are not speculative in nature. They give you the actual picture of the economy persisting for a particular time. Now, as I said, as a first step, the large bank companies, as if I will cover this, that how do they conduct these tests, and I'll cover this in brief. So I'll give an overview of CCAR and DFAST. Yeah, we will be giving an overview of CCAR and DFAST modeling as well. That how
no, no, Sorry, I misspelled it. Actually, I meant who conducts these tests, whether it is the bank or who's, whether it's bank's responsibility or Federal Reserve's responsibility. Okay, bank.
Yes. So when I say in the first line, it's the annual stress test applied by the Federal Reserve. That means it's mandated by the Federal Reserve.
Okay. Okay.
So this mandate is applied on the banks by the Federal Reserve.
Okay. 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 And all the variables and scenarios, these are given by Federal Reserve.
I will cover it. So the large companies have to develop these baseline adverse and severely adverse scenarios on their own as a first step. But when you are finalizing your models, you get these scenarios from the regulators on which you check your models. So for example, the model submission goes by 31st March of every year. And so say on 31st March 2019, my CCAR models have to be submitted to the Federal Bank. But when I'm actually working on CCAR models, I submit my models to the internal banking committees by 30th September 2018. So a good 6 months before the actual submission period. So when I have to prepare my model by 30th September 2018, I will start the preparation of my model say by April 2018. So I will have April, May, June, July, August, all a good 5 or 6 months to prepare my model. The Federal Bank will provide me the scenarios say by June or July. So mostly when a bank makes a scenario of baseline adverse and severely adverse, they take into account the scenario which was provided by a Federal Bank in the previous year's submission. So when the banks start preparing their own scenarios and they start building their models in the month of March or April, they have some macroeconomic indicators with the from the Federal Bank, but they are of the previous period. Since they have to do their internal submissions by 30th September, and it is also a mandate from a central bank that banks also have to develop their own macroeconomic scenario. They do develop it on the basis of their internal calculation, which is done by another team which sits in the bank and calculate this scenario going forward. They start building these models. And once the finalized scenarios from the regulators or the Federal Bank come by, say, June or July, or say by July or beginning of August, then they apply this scenario to your existing model, which we have developed till now. Okay. So when you start building your model, say by April or May, when you get the whole complete data for your portfolio, you use your own scenarios, which is also mandated by the bank. And once you get the scenarios from the central bank, so you use the same variables with the different values in your own model. So while you are doing submission, while a big bank like Citibank or American Express, they have to do their CCAR submissions to the bank, in the document, they have to mention what were the baseline adverse and severe adverse scenarios according to their own calculations and what were the scenarios which were provided by the central bank. So this is a practical thing to make. See, you are making a model, started making model in April, May, and you get the scenario by July end. And after that, if the macroeconomic scenario received from the Federal Bank is too much different, then your whole modeling process will go for a toss. So that's why What we do is a bank, when they are making a macroeconomic scenario, they consider the different macroeconomic scenarios given by the Federal Bank till now. And on those similar lines, they develop their own macroeconomic scenario. So that when the actual scenarios come, they are not much different from the scenarios which bank has developed internally. Okay. A difference between this type of submission and Basel is, in the Basel, you take a further period of 12 months. But in CCAR DFAST, you calculate your losses for a 9-quarter horizon. Okay. Now, and again, a quick explanation, what is baseline, what is adverse, and what is severely adverse. So baseline scenario is the most current scenario which you can expect for the bank. And adverse and severely adverse scenarios are a hypothetical scenarios. A scenario in case the economy goes bad, a scenario in case the economy goes very bad, that is severely adverse. So for example, I can, when I develop the CCAR model, say with my adverse scenario, the total losses, the total predicted losses in my portfolio after, including all EAD and recovery rate and everything, say was coming around $5 billion. For the 9 quarters. But with the adverse scenarios, my losses went up to around $7.5 billion. And when I use a severely adverse scenarios, my losses shot up to say $10.5 or $11 billion. So this is the huge difference which is just created by a different condition in the economy. And that is why this stress test is done. Again, in CCAR DFAST, we prepare, as I said, we prepare the PD model, we prepare the LGD model, we prepare EDAD model, and then you multiply to calculate the losses. And here the losses is for, prediction is for 9 quarters. So, in a way, this is a more stringent test because you have to commit the health of your bank for the next 9 quarters. Right, which is almost more than 2 years. So you are assessing the health of your portfolio, of your credit risk standing for the next two plus years. So in a way it is more stringent and it is more comprehensive in nature, and it is more confidence building for the customers and for the investors. Now briefly, when you develop a CCAR or DFAST model, so you develop two models simultaneously on a similar portfolio with the different methodologies. So one type of model is called as champion model. So champion model is nothing but the main model through which you are doing your loss calculations. And to challenge that or to re-verify that, bank has to adopt a different methodology and develop a different set of models as well on the similar portfolio using the similar macroeconomic variables. So in a way, it's a double layer on your loss calculations. A small example would be, which I worked upon, is as a champion model, you develop account level models for PD, LGD and EAD and calculate the loss and losses at the account level, and then you sum it up. And what you do is you divide your portfolio into particular segments and then you build one model for one particular segment. So you will have, say if you have 10 segments, you will have 10 different equations, and out of which you will come out with one particular loss number. So you will try and match these two loss numbers, and they should not be too much different. So in case your challenger methodology gives you a different number of loss, then you are yourself contradicting your main model. So in a way, you are rechecking your model yourself with a different methodology by using the same variable, same macroeconomic variable. Apart from that, in CCAR, there is a separate documentation which you have to do. So earlier, CCAR document in 2014 and 15, it was more an open-ended. So companies or the bank holding companies which were submitting those models, they have to define the modeling methodology in their way and put on the results. Now, every page of a CCAR model submission has a question. Again, that you have to answer. For example, they will ask you what are the variables you have used. Second question, why you have not used this kind of variable? Third, what is the treatment you have done on your data? Fourth, what kind of different methodologies you have tried before arriving at this particular champion challenger methodology? Fifth, how you justify your segmentation approach? So it is a very extensive document, and documentation filling sometimes takes, it takes up around one month, I would say, for 1 or 2% when they are working on it. So it is very extensive and huge. And when you do a submission, the internal submission by 30th September, then those models goes to different validation committees within the bank. So there would be model validation committees. There would be some committees which will check the methodology which you have used in the model, whether you have used it correctly or not. All those kind of stuff goes on for the next 6 months when you validate your models. Then before going to Federal Bank as well, they have a validation committee to which these models go, and they check it at a primitive level. So a lot of things goes on for the next 6 months. So say, for 4 or 5 months you're building the model, but for the next 6 months the model is going through multiple scrutinies, and any kind of change which is suggested by any committee, if it is small change, you usually do it in the same cycle. So for example, I would say when we develop the model, we use primarily 4 or 5 macroeconomic variables, and we were using the similar kind of macroeconomic variables since 2 to 3 years. We try to fit in this variable or at least justify why this particular variable is not coming significant for your model. So we have to check this thing again and provide a complete separate documentation to our internal committee that why this particular variable is not coming significant, and it will not provide me any new information value for my model. So this should come out from internal committee, and then only these models get finalized. So this was the internal stuff. Now, very briefly, I will cover CCAR and DFAST difference. So on a very broader scale, by more of the requirement of the bigger banks. So when you say the large banks have to do the DFAST as well annually, there are some extra conditions which they have to fulfill because they are a large bank holding company, and they have more effect on the economy if they go bad. Also, when we talked about the scenarios, so the large banks are required to create their own scenarios, but if you talk about the smaller banks, they can use the scenarios provided by the federal bank, because the smaller bank may not have the proper teams and mechanism to develop their own scenarios. So in a way, CCAR and DFAST, they are complementary to each other. They have a similar kind of processes and supervisory exercises and requirements. So basically, the federal bank coordinates between these two and expects a submission from the bank holding companies. So all in all, CCAR DFAST was implemented after the 2008 recession to include the effects of the macroeconomic variables, how they can impact your portfolio, your credit risk standing, and how to safeguard and provide additional capital tapping to the banks in case the economy goes for a toss. Okay.